Hello, today is May 28th, and this is update number 8 from the city of Solon on the coronavirus. I'm William Shaw, retired fire chief. Many decisions made early on regarding the current public health emergency were made on information available at that time. As we have seen, there wasn't much information then, as this was a new virus never before experienced. Over the past few months, new data and information on how to safely go about our lives has been developed. As we all settle into our new normal, whatever that may be, Mayor Krause has been constantly monitoring these developments with the goal of keeping the residents and staff in Solon safe and healthy. We are happy to announce that the Solon Center for the Arts summer camps will begin June 8th, as previously scheduled. Of course, there will be modifications to ensure the safety of campers and staff. Face masks will be worn by all SCA staffers, and masks are highly recommended for the participants while inside the facility or in close proximity to an instructor. Masks may be removed if outside and practicing safe social distancing. Updated waivers will need to be signed by all participants. New waivers can be completed the first day of a program if necessary. All camp participants will have their temperature checked upon arrival. Anyone with a temperature of greater than 100 degrees will be denied entry to the building. A health assessment must be completed by each participant prior to entering the building. Regular hand washing is scheduled and may be increased depending on activity. Drop-off and pickup will be done outside. Parents or caretakers should follow the flow of traffic and remain in their cars, preferably wearing a mask. A detailed email containing all new guidelines will be sent to all participants prior to the start of their program and summer camp. Limited registration is still available and can be completed online at http://solonarts.maxgalaxy.net. The Solon Service Department is making available to residents 15-yard dumpsters, which can be used for residential rubbish. This replaces the former truck drop-off program. If you are cleaning out your house, working on a small home improvement project, or have a lot of yard waste, you may request a dumpster via the Service Department website. Each dumpster must contain only one type of material, such as rubbish, construction debris, or yard waste. Materials cannot be mixed in the same dumpster. The Solon Community Center will begin a phased-in reopening, beginning Tuesday, June 9th, with modified days and hours of operations. The center will be open Tuesday through Fridays from 6 o'clock a.m. until 8 o'clock p.m. and weekends from 8 o'clock a.m. until 6 o'clock p.m. The center will be closed Mondays. Only the fitness equipment from the fitness mezzanine will be available. The equipment will be moved to achieve proper social distancing. The indoor pool will also be available for lap and fitness swimming. Appointments must be made for pool use and is limited to 45 minutes on the hour. Only one person per lane will be allowed and two in the current stream. Instructions on how to make reservations will be available beginning the week of June 1st. The Arthur Road Pool will be open June 17 with a 50-person limit. The pool will be open Wednesday through Sunday from 1 o'clock p.m. until 8 o'clock p.m. with 3 2-hour periods available. 1 o'clock to 3 o'clock, 3:30 to 5:30, and 6 o'clock until 8 o'clock. Availability will be first come, first served. Please continue to find information both at solonohio.org and on the Solon Rec Facebook page. We want to remind everyone that the threat from the coronavirus is not over. We say this not to cause fear, but as a reminder that as we come together, hand washing, social distancing, and face masks are still vitally important to the health of our community. Even though the virus is still present, we are constantly looking for ways to engage our community and continue with providing the excellent services residents have come to expect. Mayor Krause is committed to your safety and will continue to evaluate developments so that service continues in a safe and healthy manner. Thank you and stay healthy.